I'm David Muir. We come on the air at this hour because there is breaking news. Be an emergency order to ground all of those 737 MAX 8 planes.
The pilot mentioned that he had difficulty and he wants to return. We will have to comply with the international regulation.
Let's talk about the realities of transportation safety and technology. According to airline experts, the most dangerous part of your trip on an airplane is actually the ride to the airport. The irony is that as we make our transportation systems safer and safer, then we get more sensationalized around single incidents. It's important for us to learn from these incidents, but not to be afraid. Not to be afraid of technology and the fundamental new levels of safety that's attained through the application of technology in all modes of transportation. When technology fails, it's ultimately human error. It's we humans that put the technology together to make our systems safer. In the case of the 737 MAX 8, there was a strong desire to reduce the cost of pilot training, and technology was introduced to have a pilot be able to fly both old and new 737s. A great example of how technology is being used to improve safety is the introduction of airbags in passenger vehicles. Over 50,000 lives have been saved in the United States alone due to this technology. For every fatality attributed to faulty airbags, over 100 lives have been saved. This is the choices that we need to make. Although technology isn't perfect, it's making all modes of transportation safer every single day. When technology is introduced to drive safety, there's a natural reaction to pay close attention to what's going on with the new technology. And it's important for us to see it perform and learn from it and iterate quickly. But we have to look at the broader facts. We have to look at the broader facts of safety so that we continue to drive forward to new levels. This is very present right in front of us with regard to autonomous vehicles. Autonomous vehicles have the potential to save hundreds of thousands of lives worldwide in any given year. However, we also have to look at the broad picture. There will be fatalities that are due to autonomous vehicle. We have to decide as a society, what's more important? 35,000 lives per year in the United States? Do we want to drive it to 3,500 through the use of autonomous vehicles, or do we want perfection? When we lose a loved one, do we care if it's at the hands of another human, at the hands of an autonomous vehicle? What really matters is how many lives we can save in totality to minimize the loss of life and minimize the heartbreak that comes to many thousands of people every year. Technology is not utopia. It will never lead to zero incidents. However, it can lead us to much higher levels of safety. These are difficult topics, and I welcome all of you to join me on LinkedIn to discuss safety and technology as we move forward.